I'm the director of Gatoto Integrated Development Program, and I would wish to share a story about Betty and about Gatoto. Betty is an alumni of Amani, first class 2013. And when Betty was growing up, she admired her English teacher. She admired the way the teacher spoke English. She admired the way the teacher dressed. And I really wanted to be a teacher in life. And here I am. I am a teacher by profession. Getting to this level was not easy because I'm the 10th born in a family of 10. My parents, being peasants, they didn't have enough money to take me through school. So my secondary school education was very hard, especially in Form 1. Because I wasn't involved in any activity in school. Therefore, when I reached Form 2, I joined extracurricular activities where I was in drama, netball, and basketball. And therefore, the school needed my services throughout the year, so they couldn't send me away. I stayed in school all throughout. But at the end of the 4 years, I definitely needed to pay that money. And by that time, my father had passed on, and it was only my mother who was there. Therefore, she sold all the maize she had planted that year to raise money to clear my school fees to get my certificates after Form 4. I was lucky because I was employed as an untrained teacher, where I taught for 1 year. And fortunately, after that 1 year, my services were terminated. And by the time my services were terminated, I realized I was already pregnant. And having been a small girl who was proud, who had always bragged how she was going to be a teacher, I felt embarrassed to go back home pregnant. Therefore, I decided to get married. Marriage life was not easy. And especially now that we both had lost our jobs, we came to Nairobi. And in Nairobi, I decided I wasn't going to stay hungry the way I was staying hungry at home. Sometimes we would go without food. And therefore, I decided to set up a small business. And in this small business, I was earning at least Kenyan shillings 15,000 per month from the business. And the business was doing very well. And our family was happy. That was back then. Later on in the year, my passion for being a teacher had not died. I still had wanted to become a teacher. And the opportunity arose when the community of Mukuru Kwa Ruben wanted to start or set up a school. And I thought, I won't miss this chance. I went for the interviews. 24 of us were interviewed. And I did the interview. And fortunately, because I had worked as a teacher before, I was chosen to be the head teacher of the school. So I took on the role of the head teacher. And being the head teacher has its own responsibilities. And I was the highest paid teacher. I had to get a salary cut from 15,000 Kenya shillings per month to 1,000 shillings per month. That did not go well with my husband. How could you leave a well-paying job to go and get 1,000 bob? We have suffered enough. Why have you taken this job? I said I wanted to be a teacher, and that is what I will be. Then I was told to choose between the school and the marriage. And I say to myself, the marriage can stay. If I can give an opportunity to any other child out there, I will do that. So I quit my marriage 17 years ago, and I'm still standing, and I'm still working for Gatoto. And I'm happy to do what I'm doing. Gatoto, as a community school, when we started it, we had a population of 370 children. As I stand in front of you today, we have a population of 1,092 children in the primary school. When we started Gatoto as a community school, we did not have any classes. We started in a church. The church was not even this big. This space is too big for my school. We had a small section of the church that we used. And they didn't have partition. So class one would face there being taught maths. Class two will face this side being taught English. Class three will face there being taught Kiswahili. And the small ones, the pre-unit and nursery, will be here singing and dancing. And we sat for a common exam, a divisional exam in Embakasi, where we are situated. And we were last in all the exams and in all the classes. I was a young head teacher. I was only 25. My dressing code was so poor. And I go for this head teacher's meeting, and I'm asked to stand up and explain why my school is last in all the exams, in all the classes. I thought to myself, I think he's not serious. Why? What will I tell them? Yes, my school is last. We don't have textbooks. Children are writing on their laps. We don't have anything. So why would I stand up to explain this? All the head teachers there were looking for that head teacher, the non-performing head teacher. And I thought to myself, if I can't stand up for those 370 children, who will? I am their head. I have come here to represent them. Therefore, I should stand up and explain. And this is my explanation. I'm humbly inviting you to come to our school and see why we are last in all the exams and in all the classes. And I sat down. That was very annoying. That was very annoying to my colleagues who are the head teachers. They needed an explanation and facts and figures to why the school was not performing. And that was a simple answer I had given. That person actually stood up because he knew I was shaken. From the way I stood up, he looked at me and knew, I think she's finished. So he rose up and told them, I have understood her and I'll visit the project to see why they are last in all the exams and in all the classes. True to his word, he came to Gatoto, and when he came in the afternoon. There's no signpost on the road showing where Gatoto is. Gatoto was in a church. And inside that church, it was in the middle of the village. So to locate it was hard. He had to go to a neighboring school and ask for directions, where he was given a child who led him to where we were. When he arrived that afternoon, we had moved our benches on the sides because there was no space to play. And therefore, this small space we had, we needed to improvise it as our field. And it was games time, so we were playing. And he walks in and asked me, Betty, where is the school? Please take me to your school. I told him, sir, you are right inside the school. Welcome. He shook his head. And because the children were so happy, they have seen a new face, they think it is a new teacher who has come in. So they came all around him. They were calling him teacher, 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 not knowing this is my boss. And maybe their future depends on him. He might close down the institution. He looked at me and said, Betty, you are doing a great job. You are doing a fantastic job. And that is where our strength and our love and our faith grew from. And as we speak now, Gatoto is no longer in the church. Gatoto now has some 11 permanent classrooms that we use. We still have some classes that are not yet permanent, but we are happy at least every classroom or every group of our students have their own class without sharing one room. And Gatoto is no longer just a community primary school. We are a registered NGO that has three programs. We do the primary school, we have a community support program, and we also do a scholarship program. As I speak to you now, Gatoto has over 20 students who have graduated from university. Gatoto has 20 students who are currently pursuing their university degrees. There are students from Gatoto who are working with the Kenya Defense Force. We have students from Gatoto who are working as bankers. There are some students who are working as lawyers. And there is this one particular student whom we have nurtured from a very young, tender age from his primary school education. We've worked with him to secondary education. And now from the larger Mukuru community, he's doing medicine at Kenyatta University. His name is Bivens Bernard. And we are looking back and we are saying all is not in vain. And we are happy that we have been able to make a difference in the life of someone. And I'm telling you this afternoon, we all here have a special calling. And in our different fields, we can make a difference in the life of a person. It doesn't matter how little you might think it is. All I can tell you is one day at a time, see Jesus. Thank you.